video. I just thought today that we could do sort of like a poster design of some sort. Be nothing super fancy. Again, it's just trying to, you know, work on my skills a little bit. I'm not really fully sure what exactly gonna do for a poster there, but typically when I get an idea to do something, I've been seeing a lot of cool posts on Reddit, so I've just sort of been, you know, I guess stealing their ideas. But I find, you know, the best way to learn something is really to you know, practice doing it, and you know, it's just a really good way I find to kind of practice, you know, what I've been doing, and you know, just kind of work on my skills a little bit. So yeah, it's gonna be nothing too special, I don't think, but you know, we'll see how it goes. So yeah, you know, there's been a couple new things going on with me right now. Like I mentioned in my previous video, I happen to have gotten a new job. So far, it's been absolutely unreal. You know, it's right up my alley. It's, you know, exactly what I've been, you know, went to school for, and you know, it's something that's really exciting and lets me do things that I haven't normally gotten to do for work. So, you know, it's been really cool. I know there's a way to do this. Let's try it like that. Bigger, just so that they're offsetting a little bit like that. And with this one, we'll go purple to maybe gray. Okay. Maybe something like so you get the two contrasts in color. Now again, it's gonna look pretty bad here until I can start to get it kind of figured out together. So let's go with that. Anytime if you find yourself having trouble, because I know that I usually have, coloring in an object like so, typically you're just going to have to rasterize it, which basically just means that you're able to edit it there. So then, as you can see, I'm able to edit the colors there and change it. Alright, let's put another circle here. Kind of like that. So it's like sort of coming out of it. What I've done is I already found this image here, so I'm going to create a clipping mask So a clipping mask for the second circle and post it in. What the clipping mask allows me to do is edit the one circle without. Let's find a good pattern. Yeah, without it posting in, so it just posts within within that circle there. So, and you want to find a nice sized image so that it doesn't distort it too much. Yeah, I really like that. Okay, so let's bring that up. Okay, and what I'm gonna do, just so I can make it look a little bit better, is let's go for color balance. And in order to kind of make it match our poster a little bit more, we're trying to just sort of, you know, it's trial and error. Yeah, it looks pretty good. It kind of matches our color scheme. So we'll go with something like that. Looks pretty good. What I'm going to do here is add some brushes. Let's see. Let's rasterize that. And I think I'm going to make this brush a black color. I don't like that one. Hardness all the way down to 0. I mean, we can sort of color around the outside of it like that. I'm trying to only really get it to go on, you know, this one side of it. Yeah, something like that looks pretty good. Like that, so it almost looks like, you know, this circle has like a shadow around it. I'd be curious to see. I could do it. Yeah, sort of like that. Kind of gives it a little bit more depth. sorry about that. I'm also in the process of trying to quit smoking. And it's incredibly, incredibly difficult for anyone who's ever done it. Let's see. So I did that one in black. I'd like to do this one in sort of a white color. Let's see, actually, we could probably do something very similar to what we did on this side. Sort of like that. Puffs it out a little more. So then you're getting sort of a white and a colored back. Colored background there. I'm not fully sold on that just being white. Yeah, see, I kind of wanted to have a little bit of color in it as well. Maybe closer to pink. Something like that. We could also go dark with it as well. You know, give it like a magenta. Actually, let me try what it would look like with that background right there. Actually, that doesn't look too bad because then it almost looks like it's coming out. So it's like coming out of there. So, I might also do a brush to kind of pop that out like so. Yeah, again, nothing really has to be perfect. You know, it doesn't have to look the best. Oops. I'll go with that. And on this rectangle there, maybe a bit more color coming out of it. guys, on the first rectangle, maybe we'll add a bit more white. Yeah, something like that. Something sort of like that. Now, what we can do is we can... Sorry about that. So, looks like my version of Photoshop kind of came into a little bit of a difficulty. I'm not really fully sure what exactly that was, but... Oh well, so it changed the color of this rectangle. So actually what I did was I kind of edited them a little bit so that... Oops, that's not what I wanted to do. Yeah, so I kind of edited them so that they were the same colors. just opposites. But I actually, you know, I think that kind of worked out a little bit well. So, what I'm going to do right now is just redo the shading that I had done. Oops. So something sort of like that to give it a little bit of color. And then again on this side, I'm going to, oops. And then yeah, again on this side, I'm gonna do the same thing, but in white. So that they're kind of opposing colors like that. And I am going to, underneath this one, add just a bit of white like that as well. And I think that that kind of gives it, you know, some good background color right there, like so. I think it looks pretty good. You'll notice that the rectangles aren't the same sizes. That is done on purpose, just because I think the title I'm going to give for this is Perfect Lines, which is, you know, I guess, I don't know if ironic is the right word, but it's supposed to be, you know, a thing of perfect lines, but they're not perfect lines. So deep and so clever, I know. Okay, so let me see. You know, maybe I could do something kind of like this. Just kind of going through and looking at, you know, maybe just different textures or different things that I could have. So you could have maybe some paint leaking, or I don't really like those. Let me see. Do something sort of like this. Let's just see what that looks like. No, I don't like that. And that's kind of one of the fun things about it is, you know, you never really know what something's gonna look like until you kind of try it, you know. Let me see. I don't want it going down too far, so you could have something kind of like that. I like it up there. I don't really so much like it on the bottom, so let's put that there and let's try. See, this spray paint ones don't really work too well with these. Again, I apologize for all the coughing. I know it's probably a little distracting. Splatter size, we could maybe, you know, just add some of these in here. You know, I don't actually mind those too much. So we'll put a couple of those in there, sure. And maybe some of those. But you know what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna change the colors on them. To take off all of those right there. So you know what? I'll never be able to find that specific brush again, I bet. Oops. It's kind of another one of those things where you find a good brush and then you never seem to able to find it again, but you know, it's a lot of trial and error just to see exactly, you know, what you might want. Again, that kind of, you know, that kind of becomes the fun of it, is, you know, seeing what you think works and what doesn't. You could put a couple of those, but, you know, I think it kind of ruins them too much. So what I'm gonna do is just do this. Couple lines. I want to make them very small though, so that they're almost not too noticeable. Something like that. Do instead, just because I can't seem to pick any specific one of these, is let's go through and pick a sample here, something that we can use for text. It doesn't have to be anything too special, actually. Something quite simple might work the best. See, I want to just see. So perfect lines. I kind of like that text actually. So we'll change the color of it and we're just going to make them black. Yep. And we'll put them a little bit bigger. So that we have that like that. Them around and just oops. perhaps. To move them around so that they can go on both both rectangles. So let's gonna move them all the way up there. Yeah, that way that they can go anywhere. Perfect, like so. And we can do lines that kind of looks like this. So, as you can see, they're not perfect lines. How avant-garde of me, what if we made them 90? That's probably what we should do. Just bear with me here. I know I'm probably not doing this the ideal way, but I'm doing this the way that I know how. And it works fine for me. Might take a little longer, but I even might add some periods in there too. I don't know how they would look. I kind of like the size of the lines there though, for the word lines. So we'll try and bring those in so they're like perfect lines. Like that. Kind of separated a little bit, like so. I could probably bring this down. That way it'd fill out the picture a little more. And bring that down like that so you have perfect lines. So you got the glow up there, the background color, so it's almost like it's chopped out. The silhouettes are out there. I kind of like it because it brings out the photo a little bit more. What else could we do here to make this? Let's just see what that looks like, just like that. And then if I brought that in, like so. Think that it needs it. If I move that E, that makes that look a little bit better. So perfect lines, like so. Yeah, I mean, it's not, it's not perfect or anything like that. Let's see. Maybe you could add a couple brushes, but I'm a little skeptical just based on, when I was working with it before, just kind of how it turned out. Let's see. Maybe if I... Well, we would probably want to lower the size and increase the splatter size. What if we kind of just did that? Maybe to give it just like a... No, I don't like that already. Let's see. Again, this is sort of, you know, where the fun comes into it. You can really kind of, you know, play, make it your own. You know, if you don't like it like that, change the opacity and, you know, maybe make it a little darker. Now, I don't like that, but, you know, it's just one of the things that you can do that you can really make these posters your own. You know, there's no right or wrong really when you're doing it. I don't like that one for sure. I don't really like those. I kind of almost just like it when it's simple like that. You know, it kind of pops out nicely. You know, you got the circle there that kind of almost looks like it's a planet in a sense. You know, it's popping out from the center. You've got the perfect lines. Yeah, I mean, it's not, you know, it's nothing special, but I think it's pretty simple, pretty easy to make, and you know, I'm kind of happy with how it turned out. But again, these are just something to, you know, kind of help me practice a little bit of skills. You know, doing some shading. And just kind of working on some creative ideas there. So, overall, I think I'm satisfied with how it turned out. It's nothing special again, like I said. But, you know, maybe if I was going back, you know, could redo this rectangle in, you know, maybe a more of a magenta color, like if you had it, you know, with that purple, and if this was more, more like that color. It just like that for now. What I could do actually though, what I might do is just do this. Oops. Okay, so we got a new layer on there. Perfect. Maybe just like that big, and we will fill it black, but then turn down the opacity on it. So it kind of almost darkens it, and then, oops, let's delete that, and then, oops, adjustments, I believe it's under there, right? Yes, it is, okay, so let's rasterize it. Adjustments, we will do, I know it's somewhere, layer, type, select, there it is, blur, Gaussian blur, and, because you see how if it's like that, it's almost like it's a steady line. Doesn't look as good, right? So if we can kind of so that it's barely visible, but it kind of sharpens it up a little bit. And then we can turn on the opacity like so. Move that a little bit over, just like that. Yeah, so, and then what I'm gonna do is, I believe that that is the, yeah, so let's add another layer right there. Do the same thing, right about there. Fill it with black. And rasterize it so that we can color it. Blur. Gaussian blur. And yeah, something like that. And then we'll just sort of move it down, downwards like so. I kind of like that one more than I like this one. So I'm just going to redo it. Yeah, like that. Again, we'll fill it with a different color. Rasterize it so that we're able to edit it. Blur, Gaussian blur. And again, nothing too crazy, just kind of something that, you know, maybe brings it out so that we're able to actually get a little peek of it. So, you know, something little. Let's do that. Yeah. Because I don't want it too much or anything. That's going to be the last one, I believe. Filter, we'll Gaussian blur it. And, oops. Yeah, it's a lot more noticeable on the pink. That's why I don't want it too strong. Yeah, something just like that. And that way it kind of gives it a little bit more depth. It kind of just looks a little bit cleaner. But yeah, I think that's going to be my poster for today. Thank you guys all for watching, and we'll see you next time.